This video is sponsored by Into the AM. Welcome back to Odyssey News. I am Mike Odyssey, and today's video we have rapid fire news with good news. And of course, our main story of the day, a huge IP is about to drop on Nintendo Switch, and I am super excited to talk about it. Let's get started. Welcome to the Odyssey. Hit the like, press play. You're running with the squad like Xenoblade. Drive like Mario. We on a... All right, team. So we've been tasked to create an ad for the Into the AM clothing company, and I want to, you know, just let you guys know. I gave you guys each samples so you guys can wear them. Tell me how they feel. Wow, Into the AM. Into the AM. Yeah, we've got the company name. That's done. So soft, oh soft. It fits so well. Okay, guys, we have to kind of focus on the key points here. Into the AM, they want to focus on how great the feel of the shirt is, how it fits, right? How it fits. Also, the quality of the graphics and the overall quality of the shirt itself and, you know, the other products they sell as well. So, anybody have any suggestions?
It fits so well. Into the AM.
You know what? Give me that Into the AM hoodie over there and give me that Into the AM cap over there and I'll come with the ad myself. You guys are just too much. Too much.
So soft and so comfy. Into the AM. Into the AM? I love Into the AM.
A huge thanks to Into the AM for sponsoring this video. Links are down below in the description. Make sure to use code Odyssey at checkout. All right, the first up in rapid fire news, we have the latest Famitsu charts, and we have Tears of the Kingdom at number 1, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe at number 2, The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild at number 3, good on you, Legend of Zelda, Pokemon Scarlet and Violet at number 4, we have Minecraft Switch Edition at number 5, Kirby's Return to Dream Land at number 6, Super Smash Bros. At number 7, Splatoon 3 at number 8, Mega Man Battle Network Legacy Collection at number 9, and Nintendo Switch Sports at number 10. Other news, we have The Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom just received an update to 1.1.2. So if you are playing The Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom, go ahead and update to version 1.1.2. Just a basically quick update there. It might fix a lot of the bugs that cause you to get duplicate items. Who knows? Update at your own risk. You probably cannot play without updating it, so there you have it. Moving on, Super Mario Advance 1, 2, and 3 are now available on Nintendo Switch Online Plus Expansion Pack. So this involves 3 games for the Game Boy Advance, and it is Super Mario Advance, which is basically Super Mario 2 from the NES. We got Super Mario World, which is Super Mario Advance 2, and Yoshi's Island, which is Super Mario Advance 3, and you can play it now. You do need a Nintendo Online membership to get these games. All right, and last but not least, fantastic news for Pokemon fans all over the world, because finally, Pokemon Scarlet and Violet connectivity coming to Pokemon Home next week. That means that you get to save and back up all those shinies that never existed for me. And, you know, all those Pokemon, rare Pokemon that you've been catching. And, you get to back him up because, you know, Pokemon Violet and Scarlet does not have cloud save. So Pokemon Home is your only solution to save your Pokemon. So make sure that you never lose them. So there you have that. All right, that is going to do it for Rapid Fire News. Let's move on to today's top story. All right, so this massive, huge game that I'm talking about that has the potential to arrive very soon, to be announced very soon, is none other than Donkey Kong. Yes, you heard me right. Donkey Kong. Now, Mike, why do you think that Donkey Kong might be coming soon? Well, it has to do with the trademark that Nintendo just submitted and were just granted, right? And let's just jump right in. I'm not going to make you wait that much. I'm just going to go ahead and show you right here. Right here, this is basically all of the trademarks that Nintendo still has live with the name Donkey Kong. A lot of them are very old, you can tell, but some of them are kind of hidden. Right now, this just says Donkey Kong, right? But you can tell this is a really old one, right? And if we go back here, there's another one that says Donkey Kong, but this one is just has a lot of information on it, okay? And now they are protecting this with everything they have. They registered this Donkey Kong name, recorded electronic game programs, downloadable electronic game programs, recorded video game programs, downloadable video game programs. So that's it's a video game. Video game cartridge, like the game cartridge. All right, Donkey Kong right here. And let's look at the publishing date. Okay, Nintendo will always publish either a patent and a trademark before they release a game. And we are going to see the filing date was July 4th, 2022. That was last year, okay? Publishing date, February 21st, 2023. And then registration date, May 9th, 2023. That's this year. That's this month, right? So now the actual patent or the trademark is live. It's officially live. And it was registered by Nintendo of America Corporation, Washington, in Redmond, Washington. That's where there were Nintendo's headquarters here in Nintendo of America here in the United States. And yeah, we have a brand new trademark that was just, you know, issued and given to Nintendo for none other than Donkey Kong. Now, what does this mean when it comes to Donkey Kong? Are we getting a brand new Donkey Kong at the end of the Switch's cycle? Or is this a new Donkey Kong that we're getting maybe for the next Nintendo console? I mean, there's still so much in the air when it comes to what's coming next. The month is the rest of the year, besides Pikmin 4, is completely empty. Nintendo, you know, Nintendo's ball is on their court, right? They have everything, all the power. They're the ones who know what's going on. We have no clue. Everything is up in the air. There has been no signs whatsoever, or any insider have reported that nothing is happening. We have never been so quiet before in the world of gaming and Nintendo, and we don't know what's going to happen. And literally anything can happen. Now, the fact that this Donkey Kong game was issued a new trademark, and it's protected over everything, okay? Everything. It has wrapping paper, bags, snacks, everything. I mean, children blanket. It has every single thing, but the major thing is the first part of the trademark that involves electronic video games, okay? So this is what it's for. Now, what if Nintendo is also registering this for the Donkey Kong movie? We don't know if this is the case. All we know is that it also says fictional stories, booklets, manuals, and newsletters, ebooks, publications, recorded computer game software, downloadable computer game software. I mean, cellular game software, downloadable images, artwork, video featurings, you know, video featuring video games. I mean, there's so much that is protected under this brand new one. Now, I'll take you back to the other ones, right? Why would Nintendo have basically two here? This is the one we just saw, but if we go back, we can see that this one is an older one. It also says video games, but you see it's limited. It's very limited. It only protects in the video game area. But this one right here, the new one, literally has all types of protection in their video games. I mean, all over the world, Christmas trees, except lights, candles, and stuff. It's just weird, you know. But yeah, we have a brand new trademark by Nintendo, you know, issued by Nintendo of America. It makes sense because they are the ones in charge of the marketing when it comes to gaming, right? Nintendo of America is the marketing department of Nintendo. Nintendo of Japan is where we develop the games, they build the games, they make the games, they come up with the games in Nintendo of Japan and headquarters. And Nintendo of America is they're the ones who market, right, to the United States and stuff. So I mean, I want to know what you guys think. This is brand new, right? If you can go over to other ones, you could tell that these are the really, really old ones right here, right? And a lot of the stuff says canceled on it. and even Mario versus Donkey Kong here. We got one from 2009. We also got Donkey Kong, Mario versus Donkey Kong again, Donkey Kong Country again, and this one is from 2020, March 2021, June 15, 2021. You know, and I'm guessing this is when they added Donkey Kong Country to Nintendo Online. They had to register it again and get a new trademark because it was going to be added to Nintendo Switch Online. So there you have it, guys. This is a very short segment here, but it's just a little proof that Nintendo is working on Donkey Kong. They have a brand new trademark to protect Donkey Kong massively. This could also very well kind of point to a Donkey Kong movie as well, even as early as next year. If Nintendo wants to continue the Nintendo Cinematic Universe and just give us a movie every single year, it is very possible that they were already working on a Donkey Kong movie at the same time as they were working on a Mario movie. Since we've already seen that Donkey Kong is animated, he's designed, he has his voice actor, and the models are already there. We've been to their land, to Donkey Kong land, to Kong Island, or whatever they call it in the Mario movie. We've been there, right? We've seen it. It's not going to change from the Donkey Kong movie, from what we saw in the Mario movie, Kong Island, or whatever it's called. It's not going to change. It's going to stay the same. So we've already seen the engine and the area where this movie is going to take place. So we don't know if maybe Mario will also be part of the movie. Maybe Princess Peach. There'll be like side characters. And Donkey Kong will be the main character with Diddy Kong and Cranky Kong and the rest of the crew. But there you have it. I mean, I'm giving you guys all the options out there. This could be a Donkey Kong game. This could be related to the Donkey Kong movie. So they want to make sure they have the trademark that protects everything related to the game. And it could well be maybe Nintendo just covering their butts to make sure that their IP is fully protected. I just want to know, what do you guys think down below in the comments? Let's continue this conversation down below, because it gets me excited that Nintendo is active. Even though we don't see them like in the front, we don't have a lot of Nintendo news happening, right? We can see that Nintendo is moving behind the scenes. And if you want to stay up to date with everything Nintendo does behind the scenes, make sure to subscribe to this channel. I'm always looking for patents, looking for movement behind the scenes for Nintendo to bring you guys things like this and give you guys all the updates inside the Nintendo world. All right, guys, that is going to do it for this episode of Odyssey News. I'm excited for Donkey Kong. Are you? And I will see you in the next awesome adventure. But before I let you go, I have two important things I need to let you know. Number one, never give up. And number two, journey on. Peace. We're on a journey, looking back on the things that we've taken for granted, but feels like we're learning to be better without what's been holding us back now.